Hey everybody, Charlie Hogwood with Survival Dispatch. In the field today, we're gonna talk about a little, I don't wanna call it a hack, I wanna call it a little survival item that we will store inside of a vehicle in case we need to self-rescue or rescue somebody else. So how many times have you ever heard of a car rolling over into a lake or a canal and they can't get the windows open? Yes, the electric windows should still work even if the car is underwater. Yes, you should still be able to roll the windows down. You probably won't be able to open a door in a submerged vehicle because of the pressure of the water holding on the door. But you can roll the window down. If for some reason that is not working and you can't roll that window down, you can pre-stage in your glove box a handy little hole punch. So what we have here is we have just a regular center punch, a spring-loaded center punch, and I have a folding knife. And I'll show you all this in a second, but the reason I have this staged the way that I do is because when I lived in South Florida, we were surrounded by canals out in the country. And sometimes a vehicle would roll into a canal, be upside down in the black water, the water would come rushing in, and you might open up your glove box and your center punch falls to the ceiling, and now you're searching around in the dark water trying to punch that window out, and you can't find the punch. So what I did is I took my center punch and I put it on some bright orange 550 paracord, and I put it in here and I tied that to a folding knife that has a seatbelt cutter, and that knife also has a window punch on it as well. So the reason I've tied it off is so that when I open this up, if I'm upside down, this thing will just self-deploy and it'll fall, and the knife will still be clipped inside of the glove box. And if I'm over in the driver's seat, all I gotta do is wave my hand around till I grab a hold of this, and now I've got it in my hand and I can pull it to me and I can utilize that. And the reason it's orange is because in the low light, I wanna be able to see that. So I can pull this now and I can pull this off. And if I still have my seatbelt wrapped on and I can't get that off, a lot of times you get hung upside down or you get into a vehicle wreck and you can't get a seatbelt off, a seatbelt cutter will come in real handy. This is just a cheap flea market knife that's a little folding blade that's got a seatbelt cutter and it has a punch in the top of it. I'm expecting I'm going to lose this in a canal somewhere, but the one time I need it, it will do what I need it to do. So I grab my orange cord, I pull this over to me, I take the seatbelt cutter, I put it across my chest and just yank down. That'll cut me loose out of the seatbelt. I can use the punch if I still need to evacuate the vehicle. Now, I also have tinted windows on my truck. Tinted windows are not going to smash and shatter the same way untinted glass will. It's going to end up in a web of plasticky material that I'm going to have to push out. Now, if I'm in the water, the water's probably going to push that whole thing in. Either way, I'll get out. There'll be less exposed edges, so that might actually work better for me. So a lot of these glove boxes don't have a convenient lip on them anymore so that you can close these in and clip a knife to them. You can drill a little zip tie or something in there, just something that you can clip this to so this remains inside the box until you yank on it and pull it out like it's coming off of a belt. So that's my handy little trick. So if I need to self-rescue or I need to grab that and go to a burning vehicle and get a family out, I'm not trying to use my hand to break a glass. I can use either of these to pop the glass, pull the people out of the burning vehicle, and you know, hopefully save the day. Who knows what's going to happen? But at least I'll have the tools at my ready to do so. So that's what I've got today for my handy little self-rescue trick. Folding knife, spring-loaded punch. You can buy them anywhere at the hardware store, at the flea market, and you're all set. This is Charlie with Survival Dispatch. I'm out.